Okay, so I'm running into a bit of a wall with the exported symbols for the importers, or rather the definition reader importers and exporters. I'm not exactly the happiest, I suppose. I don't want to overload this between, because eventually I'm going to need both the YAML and the binary ones together for import and export, which means I can't have them both loaded in at the same time, especially for earlier, let's say I'm in editor mode and the base data is binary and then the data that I'm working on top is YAML data. I can't overload the symbol for both sets. That's not going to work. So I need to change that up. So what I'm going to do is YAML foe include what I'm going to, okay, yeah, what I'm going to do is these. I'm going to basically rename this. It'll be like YAML import, YAML export, or export YAML, import YAML fragment. Yeah, something like that. So let's create a new directory to put, move this stuff in. For all that. Okay. We'll get rid of the Imex one. Between this instead. It's not this, it's YAML. Okay, let's do that, please. Yes. Simple enough. Go back in. Okay, what we'll do is cd libs resources. CD libs, we'll just get rid of that. Get rid of that subdirectory. To update these loaders, so it'll no longer be this. Quite. Foe resource YAML fragment descriptor. Why? What's not happening here? This is foe resource. Yeah, okay. Oh, still not quite going. Foe resource YAML. Oh, yep. There's a number of other things I need to do to simplify this. They will have to wait. Okay, it looks like, almost. Ah, yes, the loader sections. This laptop is not the best for this. Cannot find this. Okay. I must screw that up a little bit. I'll have a CMake list file. This being incorrect. Yes, that no longer exists. Okay. Okay, not the worst. I'll take that. All these changes are to, what was it doing? Trying to share symbols for import and export of resources. Cross both the binary and non-binary.
the current to simplify. Naming conventions, be linked in more tradition. Linked in or conventionally. Okay. So that's something. Okay, gotta pause for a second while I figure out what to do next. Okay. So, with that out of the way, I was thinking of reworking fragment descriptors and materials. The idea being, fragment descriptors are used with materials regardless at the moment. Rolling it through my mind. I'm thinking like the cases of shadow maps where the fragment descriptor would just be like the depth component. I'm just wondering if I can kind of roll it into the material system anyways. Because, okay, the differentiating part of a fragment descriptor is really the shader. Otherwise, these are like intrinsically tied to it. And this can all be rolled into a material anyways. So they'll have the resources, which won't be the fragment descriptor. Instead, the resources will be the not the fragment descriptor, but it will be what the fragment descriptor is. So the fragment shader and the other shaders along with fragment. I forget if there's any others. Fragment descriptor. No. There's no other shaders. But like all these things are kind of things we could just roll into the same. I don't see why these need to be separate. Especially since they're basically created right away. Like the loader just generates them fresh every time, for the moment anyways. Like it gets the data, checks sub resources. It's just a fragment shader. And then gets it from the frag pool. I'm not really sure if I see much point in, like, why would I want to share it that much? I already have all the data held elsewhere anyways. It's already, you can already share it from the descriptor pool. Material set what it does in. Okay, yeah, I'm gonna. That's what I'm going to do otherwise for tonight. I'm going to roll the fragment. After this 10 minutes of agonizing, I'm going to roll in the fragment descriptor resource into the material. Because what is it? What's special about it? Nothing. Other than the fact it has the sub-resource, which is the fragment shader. Okay. Okay. So that is going to be my thing. My little thing for now. So let's start. Material. Let's simplify just a little bit. So currently it's a fragment descriptor. What I want is the faux shader. Okay, we're going to do this. Include shader. I'm going to do it here. We'll see. What else do we need? Okay, where's subresource state? That's nice. Name, load state, ref count, loader, data write, log. Subresources, okay, faux graphics. Okay, fragment descriptor. VK fragment descriptor, we already bring that in. Okay. We're going to need, I mentioned from the loader. Material loader is going to require something. Pointer. Gonna pull that in. Can leave it that for the moment. Okay, it'll be the second pool type. It's the graphics pool descriptor type. That would also mean I need the shader loader stuff here as well. For that, That's the old stuff there. Okay, it's... that. We'll just have to go through on the other side to clear them out. Change that to that one. That means need to change down here when we initialize the thing. Trail loader dot initialize. We've got that. Well, now I need the end shader loader. Need that. Okay, make sure we're okay so far. Then I'll need to go into, at least make sure it compiles. Then I need to go to material sub resources. I need to add, what was it, the fragment shader, correct? Mm-hmm. Descriptor, great. Brings these guys in. Mm-hmm. Okay, so if I do this, then it should not load at all anymore. Every time it'll come through, it'll be bad. Ooh, this is actually worse. Shader get load state, material. It's not null pointer, I'm sorry. Wait. Oh, I don't. Okay, because it is null pointer, it should actually not try to load it or even check the state of it. Come on. Out. Thank you. This is going 20%. Okay, that's fine. All right. Not too shabby. Okay, so that's material. That is the material sub-resources all done and dealt with. Okay, now I need to deal with the export of the data, or the import, really. Okay, so that's what I'm using right now. And that's the fragment descriptor, which means I need to the single albedo fragment descriptor, which means I need to grab that. Then we grab the material too. This is what we're bringing in from here. Graphics data becomes this stuff. So material now has graphics data. It's slightly more together. I'm going to roll with this for the moment still. I think it'll be okay idea. It'll probably be split out again one day, but we'll have a better idea as to why. Material shader loader. Okay. We need to go into here. We need to add stuff for this. We need to add all this stuff. So we've got that, we've got the frag descriptor name, which is now going to be fragment shader name. We're going to have all these items for the graphics data. Next exporting is basically the same again. Save this. Okay, we get the fragment descriptor public stuff, along with material public stuff. Okay, this will be interesting. For the moment, what I can do node name, which will be that. Okay, then what I can do is this. Do I actually import both shader materials right now? The material and the material too. I do bring both in. Okay. Give me a second. This is pulling in the frag descriptor, which means we need the fragment shader. And then we've got the graphics data for it. Okay. Shader. Okay. And then we got those, and then we get the rest of this stuff. So fragment shader, and then we get out of the way, coming through everything else. It's becoming a little bit much. Do this, but it's for the fragment shader. Do I not have the M shader pool? Oh, I don't have the don't have that. All right. Time to find out. Am I at least reading stuff and I have all the data I need? Truth is, yes. I have the fragment shader, descriptor name, and a bunch of other stuff which I presume is going to be correct for now. Okay. I fragment shader this. Check all sub-resources are loaded. Okay. And definition data, create the resource. Which in this case requires me to do this. Do I really not have this? I guess I don't. Pull that in, p new frag descriptor. Oh, yes. This is where I use it. Then on this side, I need to say when I have this sub resources dot p graphics equals p new frag descriptor. Okay. Then when I'm going through to do these other things, I have accessors for material. We're doing these things. So rather than that, don't need that. Goodbye. Put this one. Oh, I can just return that then. I don't even need to check. If it's null pointer, it's null pointer. If it's not, it's not. Whichever way I return is correct. Or should be. For writing a material definition, I need to actually write out the stuff. Resource node. Okay, Okay, for the moment, what I'm going to say is, oopsie diddly doodly, I am not going to bother with it for the moment. Let's make sure I can actually just read it in and that it works. And then I can then I can think about writing it. Yes, this portion. Okay. Nice, super negative reference counts. Fantastic. Okay. One thing, first things first. Get rid of the fragment descriptor. Which means removing it from the subresource. Means yes. Wait. Oh, yes, I don't even need to do this because I'm sorry, what? Fragment descriptor, the shader. Oh, I only need this. Data dot dot p fragment shader. Okay, let's see it self-destruct. Cool, it didn't actually self-destruct. And the negative values are all gone. Classic. And I have slightly more consistent frames. But that's probably just a fluke. Okay, don't need this, nor this. This nor this. Okay, get rid of these four. They're gone. Actually, we may still need them for the moment. Oh yes, the application will be having an error because we don't need these two anymore. Debug it, make sure it runs. Good. No major issues. Should mean I can remove it from here. Okay, let's double check. Is there anything special I do when I deinitialize this? No. Just nullify a couple of pointers. So what I'll do. RM these files, move back. Move these guys. Should clear out a number of. Some things are still. Yes. Okay. These items need to be moved over. Okay, first of all, these. Do we need them? Close all, close others. Simplify. Okay. Writing material. Right now it was what the declaration is just the name, that's fine. Definition, the resource node includes a fragment shader. Which is just this. I don't have the ability to get the shader out yet. descriptor on that, if we have it. Okay, now we have that. Pfrag shader, we need to include. That's it, that's in, that's everything here. I don't even read in the image yet. No, I do not. Okay, I'll fix that in a moment. Reading definition. Wait. All right, yeah. I don't, yeah. Not bringing these things in yet. Which means calling in this one. Don't need that anymore. Writing, I still need to update that for sure. Okay, writing out the graphics data. Material. Get fragment descriptor. Yeah, that's right. Oh no, I probably need something, don't I? I probably need. No, I don't need anything. Okay, that means I no longer need this. Do that now. Read material definition. It's now this massive set of stuff. Read material definition from here. It's all that. Get rid of these two. Oh, yep, you're right. That's gone now. Material now has a shader instead. Actually, I don't even need that because I'm not even... just returning a pointer, so it doesn't need to know anything about it. Okay, so the last thing is to update the material writing. Okay, material definition. We go in. So we've got the fragment shader. We have the same thing for okay. Get image. Return whatever that is. I don't have an image declaration yet. Do we not? We do not. The declaration, or perhaps we go for the shader declaration. I believe it's just the name of it for now. Probably won't be that for long. I was writing it. Not reading, writing. Ugh. Right, image declaration, node name, almost. Okay. Okay. Now I want to see if I can write these out. Exit. Okay. And we see what this does. And before I do it, I make sure that, you know what? I have these guys saved. Yes, I do. Run it. And, okay, material 22 is a bit odd. The material. Why is it adding twos? Must have had it on from earlier. Yeah. Oh, I'm still statically linking all this on this computer. That didn't work out. Oh, because, yeah, number two was... Well, at least I know it's loading that right. Be the same thing, but just without the fragment descriptors. You got it. Yes. on the current mental map of the system. Retrieved from it's a bit redundant to say, but whatever. Need to go into libs, YAML, do. Okay, clear out a few more. Make sure that's running all fine. It is. Put that in. Okay, we've got just over an hour. Okay, I'll call it there. So that's two generally minor things done. Cheers.